You're the coolest dressed person in the room. I just thought I would lay that down.
Thank you. I make myself vulnerable all the time. But I really have a question for you. I make the same mistake over and over. So I invest in my staff. I went and saw Oprah and did this workshop, and it wasn't about being an entrepreneur, it was really about investing in these the staff member, and I have 15 of them. So I tell them, you have to be on the good path. If you lie, cheat, or steal, or hang out with people that do that, you cannot work here. You have to be a better person. So it's really, I invest in them. So I have longevity with employees. I do not, if you're late two times, you're wasting my time. So I'm tough, but I'm very kind. But when they start the shelf life, like 5 years, like one girl graduated college, and I can tell her parents are like, why are you still working at a junk store a year later? And it's wearing on her. And I see the signs that they're over it, but I still love them. I've invested in them. I keep making the same mistake over and over. So it'd be 1 year into it, and I said, why didn't I just let her go? I could tell that she was over it, but she's good, and maybe she'll come back when she was on fire, like in the first, second year, the third year. How do I tell when to let them go, to pull the Band-Aid off?
The type of business that you're in, it burns people. It's retail, right? You're in the retail business. You have a responsibility as the mother hen to know and identify when you think that person's lost their fire. And I don't think terminating them is the right approach. I think encouraging them to go spread their wings and be somebody better, be somebody different, and take pride in the fact that they came through your organization, they made a good living, you made a good living by them being there. Hopefully they've learned a lot. You've taught them about the importance of treating people the right way and setting certain standards. And at some point, the greatest compliment to all of you is people that come through your organization that go on to do bigger and better things. It really is a compliment to you because it's a testimony to the fact that they learned something and that they were inspired and that they're gonna go spread whatever teachings you gave them. And so you have to think about it that way, that you're not firing them. It's time for them to grow up.
What happened when you have those conversations? And because I've learned that lesson, I keep getting this lesson over and over. I'll say, Melissa, I know your parents, you have a degree. What are you doing here?
I know your parents?
No, her parents were telling her, what are you still working at a junk store? So I could tell she was over it. And so I'd have that one-on-one conversation. I know you're over it. I know you're sick of retail, sick of the crazies. I get it. What are you going to do? Let me help you. Let me help you with the resume.
I want you to stop right there. Has anybody ever been in a relationship where you break up with somebody and you said, look, I know you don't love me anymore. Instead of saying you don't love them, you're like, I know you don't love me anymore, and it's just not the same, and you should go do your own thing. It sounds like a bad breakup. Instead of saying, the relationship has been amazing, and I don't know how to thank you enough, but I am excited about what your future holds. We should spend some time over the next couple of weeks talking about things that you're interested in, and if I can help you in any way, invest in you, maybe you want to open up your own shop, maybe instead of saying, I know your parents don't want you to be here and I know you're sick of it, turn it around and say something totally different.
What if they don't let me go? They'll say, no, I'm looking, thanks Jessica for your support. I'm putting out my resume and I'm for them, they're for me. And then they don't want to make themselves vulnerable because they like it, it's comfortable, it's fun. I believe in the Be Nice or Else book. We all study that book, no gossiping. We have a family word team, and they don't want to leave. And then I get stuck with their leftovers for like a year. And I keep making this mistake over and over.
Well, why is it a mistake again?
Well, because they're just not 100%. They've been over it for 3 months.
Because they're not meeting their sales targets?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so then let's go back to that. Is it clear if I work for you what my sales goals are?
Yes, we have a goal sheet every day.
And if I perform and I hit those sales goals, and you're still telling me to leave?
Because it's not really so much about the, I'm investing in them. I could just tell.
No, but okay.
I'm codependent.
They're doing everything you're asking them to. They're hitting their numbers, and you can just tell that it's not right for them anymore.
Mm-hmm. I can.
But what does that mean, you could tell? They're not enthusiastic. Because don't people grow up and change?
Yes.
And so And so
they've told me that too. Like, Jessica, there's a lot of pressure. I know you want us to be better people and stuff. Can I just come to work? I'm fine. Because yeah, like I'm just, like, what's wrong?
There are people in the world, by the way, that just want to show up, work, get a check, and go home.
Yes.
And that's okay.
It is it?
Well, it's not your job to solve crime for everybody. But if they're showing up late, or they're not hitting their numbers, or they have a bad attitude, that's a different story. But if they've settled into a life that's happy for them, and you don't know all the things that are happening outside of there, they may not share them all with you, it's not for you to decide. And so we sometimes spend a lot of time as people trying to fix everybody, and because it makes us feel better about ourselves. That's the biggest problem I have. It's okay if they just do their thing. But if it's affecting the business, then that's a discussion. If it's not affecting the business, people are gonna, everybody's different. Some people just like working at a cafeteria line. And that's okay for them. And that's, maybe they have some other passion. They're artists at home at night, or they are super religious, or they write poetry. We just don't know everything about everybody. So if they don't disrupt the workplace and they're doing their thing, I would support them and encourage them. And when they're ready to spread their, give them the freedom to know that it's okay, say it once, and move on.